My name's Erik Preston. I'm a member of the Level 1 seminar staff, and I'm the owner of CrossFit San Leo. It's a small affiliate in North San Diego County, a little place in the city. So I grew up in the desert area, a small place called Indian Wells. And when I was growing up, it was tumbleweeds and jackrabbits and sand dunes, BMX bikes, and you know, just a wide open expanse. My mom was sort of the, you know, my kid's gonna be exposed to everything, so a little bit of overachievement in terms of that's what she wanted for me. So I remember doing activities ranging from BMX to acting to speed reading courses to violin. My claim to fame is that I made it through two rounds on the Gong Show and finally got cut by Chuck Barris. I was too serious, is what he said. Picture like a little black kid wearing a gypsy outfit, you know, boots and like the pants, like baggy pants and the scarf. And I had this whole song called Chartist, and it was a pianist, and it was started out slow, and then it got to me like dancing like Fiddler on the Roof. There was the military years, there were the restaurant years, there was the post-military career ADD years. Worked as a security guard, nothing sexy. I mean, it was like woodchuck to ground squirrel. You know what, I want to be a firefighter. I'd rather become a nurse. I signed up for the wrong chemistry course that took me all the way to my four-year degree in biochemistry. How does a hand become a hand and a foot become a foot was my field of study. Through the big pond of life, I've been able to find that next rock, and each one has been a rich experience. Those are certainly the early years. Now, as I'm older, I feel like it's channeled into constancy, and I'm at peace with that. And you can have your bedrock, and you can have old other pursuits. It doesn't mean that you have to let go of any of the others. And I think that's certainly the proof's in the pudding in terms of my longevity with, you know, CrossFit. Drank the Kool-Aid in a huge way, like huge way. Like, it's just amazing, just like to be on the website, on the message boards, everything's wonderful, you know, this like sense of discovery and this subculture that existed, and it's like, oh, you haven't heard of CrossFit? Let me tell you about CrossFit. How do I tell you about CrossFit? Getting those little PDFs, and they're dog-eared, and you can't wait to print the journal, and you reread it 50 times. You look in your garage, and you have your mats, and you have like two kettlebells, and you know, I remember searching far and wide for a pull-up structure that would support kipping pull-up, rings hanging from it, a whiteboard, markers, you know, a couple kettlebells, and I could not wait. I would go into the garage and just sit there and just look at your space and just say, gosh, you know what, the things I can do in this little playground. But more important, it was just the sense that, look at what I've created, you know, in my garage. And still that sense of wonder and mysticism, and the neighbors are like, what's going on in there? Really, my life, and I think many would agree with this, is CrossFit. Just now, I'm starting to get back into the things that make my life rich. I love movies, I love film. Top on the list would be Blade Runner. It's probably like the best film known to man. Thin Red Line, again, timeless themes of love, redemption, nature, violence. Ferris Bueller's Day Off. You know, film is about previews, it's about seat selection, it's about creating this holy space that transports you into the film experience. Like, I take this serious, like, to this point, like, let this crystallize the thought. I actually rammed my truck into a car's bumper because I was trying to park too fast, and because I felt I was gonna miss the previews, and the experience is lost. CrossFit is my passion, it's an opportunity for service. Truly is not a job. That's the best way I can articulate it. These individuals that you share kinship with are deserving of your best effort, and they are you and every other person that's been before you in the CrossFit community, and they're coming with wide open eyes and a love and an affinity for what we're doing. I would say that's, you know, the common experience for a Level 1 seminar attendee. And so I approach it that way, but it comes natural because it's just love of what we do.